innumerable times. He is a part of this band. Thank you. ladies and gents. So, I don't know if you guys have heard. I'm going to guess by the numbers, because the last show we played was not, there was not as many people. I'm going to guess you guys have heard this is indeed Pilot's last show. So, we want, yeah, there's a couple of those. But seriously, from the bottom of our hearts, we want to thank you for being here tonight and sharing this with us. This is a huge deal to us and to many people we know, so we have no idea what this means to us.
You may notice some songs that are less familiar than what you've previously heard, and that is because it's from our new album, which we're releasing today.
It's called The Porcelain Influence, and it is for sale in the back. Go talk to John Norman, Studley Stud. Is he back there selling CDs? Yeah, I call him Jan Norman. No, his name's John, and I know that. Thanks. Oh. Go buy a CD. And keep listening.
Yeah. time like oxygen.
Watch it
pass us by before our eyes.
And we'll know,
and we'll play.
And just maybe this'll go away.
If we kneel, if we pray, if we give our forsaken soul.
Something. I used to work at a retail store in town here. Many of you know it. Worked there for 5 years. Anyway, there I used to walk down the aisles and I saw this thing, this Viewmaster. And it always stared at me. And it was like, it's like collector's editions, like 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. Like all these popular cult images that were just like branded into your brain through like 3D imagination. And I always liked the concept. And that's actually where this song came from. And I'm tearing myself away from that Viewmaster tonight. We have it in the back, and I'm gonna sell it to one of you guys because I'm going to New York tomorrow, and I need the money. So come talk to me after the show. We're gonna try to get that Viewmaster out of my hands.
Smell seeps in through what voice and race.
fucking sexy right now.
I'm just looking sexy right now.
So Tony thinks he's cool. He's gonna go out to the store. He's gonna go buy himself some jeans for the New York trip. He's gonna drop a pretty penny on him because it's New York and I'm not cool enough to be there and I gotta trick people that I am. Then, this is sort of trial run. He's gonna wear them at the last pilot show, right? And he's gonna freaking rip them in the middle of the set. That's the story of my life, right there. I'll see you guys in like a month. I'll be back. I'm not cool. something. And I don't know if we can still do it, guys. If you don't want to like get hurt or anything, like get out of the pit area, all right? You guys be careful. You don't hurt each other, all right? But I want to see a line of all the pitsters down the middle here. Let's just get one. You pick one side or you pick another. If you've got friends on one side, go to one side, and then get the other friends on the other side. Let's do this, all right? All right? I saw this at a dog fashion disco concert. I stole it. All right? But in a second, it's called the Wall of Death, right? Right. So that should give you some idea of people who don't want to get hurt. All right? Now you do this with the understanding that you are going to be running at your brother when we break back into this song, okay? All right? And now the moment I've been waiting for. You guys be careful. I don't want to see a single bloody nose, a single black eye. This is all fun and games. Now the moment I've been waiting for. It's time to pitch this.
Yeah.
I love you too.
Thank you.
Wes and I met in seventh grade, and we started this band called Ugly Monkey, right? It was just us and a drum machine, because we love some 9-inch nails, okay? And we called our drum machine Gay Bob. After a while, we started playing more songs. We started doing covers of Bush and Nirvana, which was, you know, which we still pull out from time to time in our, when no one's looking. But that certainly soon evolved. We got Cody Meek here when I was in eighth grade, and he was a sophomore, and that's when P.Y.L.O.T. started. So that was around the year 2000. So it has been 8 solid years since then. We had a ship soon after. This chick used to go to our shows when she was 12, and now she's 18. I used to be 12, and now I'm not. Cody used to be... July 17th, 2004 was the first time we released the CD. That's some crazy stuff, guys. Original OG groupies. Right. Ex-girlfriends galore in the audience right now. Has anybody got a P.Y.L.O.T. box for us? P.Y.L.O.T. box? P.Y.L.O.T. box! Old school, P.Y.L.O.T. box. Right. Guys, it has seriously been a solid 8 years, and we could have asked for nothing more. Wade Tucker was a huge part of this band, too, in the original part, so we need to make sure we give him a shout-out in spirit, at least. And then we need to give this man, Matt DeVore, a shout-out as well. Thank you so much, Matt, for coming in and filling shoes. Guys, this is it for us, right? We got these 2 songs, but they're really 1 song, so that's it. This is it. This is what it comes down to, right?
Let's make it memorable.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jasmine. Happy birthday to you. Jake Winchie's birthday today, too. Happy birthday, Jake. He's running sound for us tonight. Again, guys. Seriously, Glasgow's been nothing but great to us, and thank you to the venue for having us out here for this last show. This is wonderful, guys. Seriously, this is like a huge punctuation point to like a large portion of my life. So it's wonderful to have you guys all out here tonight. Thank you, guys. We're P.Y.L.O.T., by the way. And these are the Porcelain Influences.
given life, a body's only sin is to be untrue.
Stand our ground.
Hey guys, make sure you guys check out the upcoming concerts at the venue at www.myspace.com/thevenueofglasgow. Right? The venue of Glasgow. Go check that stuff out. Right? And buy our new CD, right? Come talk to us. And pre-order the DVD. This has been recorded by four different cameras, so it's a big night. Money.